Welcome, everybody, to my personal favorite night of the entire year. That's right, it's Valentine's Day. So that means that for one night only, we set horror aside to celebrate the greatest slumber party.
Sleepover.
Movie of all time. Dirty Dancing.
The music sets you dancing. The dancing sets her free.
Tonight, we celebrate the 22nd annual viewing of this timeless Slumber Party Sleepover classic with dance and snacks and dating advice from Maurice. See. And even a visit from the love doctor himself, Mr. Barnabas Klaus, here to answer all of your amorous inquiries.
Really, Sarah, you do need to...
No.
All right, everyone. There has been a slight change in plans.
No.
Yeah. No. We have just received word from the ministry that tonight's film has changed. The film, Sarah, Miss C, has changed.
No, 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 no.
Yes. It is written right there. Tonight's film has been, well, changed. We will be showing the 1963 drive-in classic, The Sadist, because, well, romance? We're going to need a few minutes to switch gears. This is quite an abrupt change. And now, a word, they changed it, a word from the ministry.
No.
This is a story about what to do on a date. It begins one early summer afternoon. It begins with Jeff and Kay and Nick. Of course, you may not have a problem about what to do on a date, but Nick, well, he has a real dating problem. Now, you may not have thought of this sort of thing as a place to take a date, but it looks like it could be fun. A group doing things together. Pretty good idea for a first date. Plenty to do, plenty of people to talk to. But let's see if Nick and Kay are enjoying it.
Are you really having a good time?
Of course I am. I'm glad you thought of coming here.
So am I. I mean, yes, it was a good idea.
Yes, it was a good idea to come here. Double dating with Jeff and Phyllis. When all four are good friends and enjoy the same things, double dates can be lots of fun.
Okay. Well, that was informative. Thank you, ministry.
Thanks.
But it does highlight something that I do think I need to bring forth now. Last weekend, I had gone down to visit Short Mooney at his shaved ice stand to treat myself to a shaved wine. When there before me appeared a hooded figure who stood directly before me and stared into my eyes with his cold, black, soulless beam. And he said to me, when the dance is canceled, context is created. I don't know. And then he took a bite of his shaved Hawaiian and disappeared seemingly into thin air. But before me, he left this, a unassuming brown paper bag from any Main Street USA, but I do believe context has been created. A dance canceled. Let's see what's in here. Okay. All right. This could have been way worse. They are just splatto cards for the sadist. They are splatto cards for the sadist. Let's just play along. Okay. Okay, splatto cards for the sadist. Here's what we'll do, the play along. You take half, and I'll take half. Actually, you have to read the lines. All right.
Delinquents taking teachers to school.
Sure, I can see that. If the schoolhouse is a junkyard and the lesson of the day is survival.
Always Coca-Cola.
Yeah, Coca-Cola didn't become the number one best-selling beverage in the entire world, not because of positive references to its product, such as this film's endorsements of it.
Junkyard ballet.
All right. I mean, all right. Arguably, there is a bit of a dance between the hunter and the hunted and the sadist, but there is nothing like a full-blown dance sequence in this movie, unless it comes from an alternate universe. So I don't know. Junkyard ballet. Be on the lookout for that.
Mm-hmm. Snakes and chains.
It would not be an Archibald Jr. movie without the appearance of one of the other. Or the other. One of the other. You guys just gave us these, snakes and chains. Watch out for snakes. Watch out for chains. I don't know. All right. We will be back with White Creek's own Happy Hoofers, Sid and Darlie, to talk you through tonight's Dirty D-inspired dance moves. Are we still doing that? Or snacks. Snacks? Are we doing snacks?
And Maurice and Dr. Blah, blah, blah. Communications in, I guess. Nobody puts Sarah in the corner. Enjoy the movie.
I have been hurt by others, and I will hurt them. I will make them suffer like I have suffered.
The words of a sadist, one of the most disruptive elements in human society. To have complete mastery over another, to make him a helpless object, to humiliate him, to enslave, to inflict moral insanity on the innocent. That is his objective, his twisted pleasure.
Thank you. strange-looking place.
What I thought. Fuel pump.
How long you think it'll take you to fix?
It has to be replaced. Take about a half an hour if they have the part. You should have one with all these wrecks around here. This back highway's good for time, but have car trouble and you got problems.
If it had to happen, I'm glad it happened where it did. And when it did, I didn't much relish the idea of being stuck in those mountains.
I'd say we're lucky. Another few miles, we'd have been in desert.
Is it what you thought, Mr. Stiles?
I'm afraid so.
Can we still make the game?
Well, we've got 40 miles to go. 12:01. Game doesn't start till 1:30. We can still make it if they have the part.
And if they don't?
This plane's stuck. If it wasn't Sunday, they could order one from Lancaster. Where the people that run this place? Hello?
You say when the player swats the ball?
Not swats the ball, Doris. Bats. The player bats the ball.
When the player bats the ball and it goes over the fence.
That's a home run.
Yes, I know, but if no one can make him out, why does he have to run around the bases?
Because he has to. That's the rules. He must touch every base. Would you like a Coke?
Oh, thank you.
Somebody could run off of the whole place, and the owner would never know it.
Okay.
Sure, thanks.
From the looks of things, nothing around here worth taking.
It's a wonder they get any business at all. Everything is so dirty and greasy.
All work isn't white-collar work, Miss Page. When I was in the army, I had my fill of this, repairing tanks. This prim and proper should have known me then.
Doris Page is a sweet girl, Ed. And a good math teacher. A little on the prudish side, perhaps.
Boy, my phys ed class calls him his ice buckets.
Mr. Oliver, I think that is a silly rule. There is no reason why a man should have to run around the bases when they can't get him out.
Isn't that a woman for you? Never seen a baseball game, and already she's changing the rules.
You should go to a ball game with my wife.
Well, I still think that's a silly rule.
If you're ever going to see any baseball today, where's the guy that runs this place?
Hey, what about some service?
Must be around here someplace. Doesn't seem likely they'd go away and leave everything wide open.
Perhaps they're around and back someplace.
Hey, anybody here? Hello? Hello?
If the pump hasn't already been stripped off that Chevy, we might be in business. We got ourselves a fuel pump, if it's any good.
Will that work on our car?
Take a few adjustments, but you get us to L.A.
I'll borrow a few wrenches and we'll soon be out of here.
Mr. Stiles has many talents.
A fine young man. Be a lucky woman that hooks him.
Why, Mr. Oliver, I do believe you're playing Cupid again.
You're only young once, Miss Page.
Why, Mr. Oliver, you sound like an old man.
Well, 52 yesterday.
Well, I'd say you'd had a fine and full life. A nice home, a lovely wife. Two handsome children.
Carl Jr. graduates from West Point in 2 weeks. Wife and I are going back for the graduation.
This guy really takes care of his tools.
I wonder where these people are.
I'll look around and see if I can find it somebody.
I don't want to shock you, Miss Page, but I'd rather not get my shirt dirty.
Oh, really, Mr. Stiles, I'm not that stuffy.
I don't know. I'm taught at the same school for over a year, and it's still Miss Page and Mr. Stiles. I do think Ed and Doris would sound a lot better.
From now on, it shall be Ed and Doris.
Just a snakeskin they shed this time of year.
I can't stand snakes.
Most people can't. Part of the country's loaded with them.
Big ones.
I hear they get to be as much as 9 feet long.
Well, I was certainly wrong, wasn't I?
Hello? Hello? Anybody here? Hello? Doris? Ed? Hello? Hello?
You never know he's the same history teacher from old Lancaster High. He really cuts loose. Today, he'll really be in his glory with his Reds playing.
I know. Edna told me last night that he hadn't seen them play since they left Cincinnati. She said ever since he got the tickets,
there's something going on here that just isn't right. Settings for four at the kitchen table, 2 plates eaten from and 2 plates untouched. Pie still warm. Except for a cat, there's not a sign of life.
The sooner we get out of here, the better off I'll feel.
Just keep working, mister. Because you're going to fix your car just like you intended.
Young man, you have no right to take our car.
Shut up.
What if I don't fix it?
You'll fix it all right, mister. You better not take too long, either.
Supposing I get it fixed, what happens then?
Me and my girl go away. Won't bother you.
How do we know you'll keep your word?
Looks like you're just gonna have to take it. Ain't you, mister? You give me your wallet.
There's not much, but you're welcome to it. Well, we're only school teachers, young man.
You hear that, Judy? We're only school teachers. We don't like school teachers. Do we, Judy?
Teachers think they're so much smarter than everybody else.
You have our money. Isn't that enough? What else do you want?
Just keep working, mister.
Teachers used to call Judy dumb. Fun of her. Send her home from school crying.
No! Stop it!
You're a pretty good size, boy. I wonder how tough you'd be without that gun.
You're one of them real big talkers, ain't you, mister? All right, big talker. Hand over your wallet. Come on! Pick it up.
You pick it up.
You a real big man in front of your lady friend. But I'm gonna show her just how big you really are.
Put down that gun and I'll show you how big you are.
I'm giving you 3 seconds, mister, to do what I say. I'm saying you pick up that wallet. One. Two.
Please do as he says.
You put it on the fender. Or do you want the gun, huh? You want the gun?
on the fender.
Big man, huh? I guess you got showed how big you really was. Start working.
Get some water. This poor man is being blinded by his own blood. Don't you even have the decency to let me care for this man? What kind of a person are you? Do you enjoy hurting others, seeing them in pain? How can you be so inhuman?
Where do you think you're going?
This man needs help and he's going to get it if you want this car fixed.
He's going to be all right, Doris. You're lucky, Carl. A little more to the right, you wouldn't be here.
If we can get you some water and in the shade, we can stop the bleeding.
What about letting this man get in the shade?
How can you be so cruel?
You get back in that car, he won't be needing nothing.
Oh, by all means, enjoy your lovemaking. But the least you can do is allow a suffering man a little water. Carrying on like that one. You're no more than an animal. You get your dirty hands off me.
You leave her alone if you want that car fixed.
And he won't fix it unless you let us get some water.
There's a pump by the house.
You get working on that car, mister. And you. Go ahead. Shoot if they move, Judy. If I hear a shot, your girlfriend is dead. Don't get no ideas. Judy don't know how to use a gun.
I wonder why he changed his mind. Ed, I don't like this.
I know something else you won't like, Carl. Remember reading last week about those brutal killings in Arizona?
And welcome back. Miss Sarah, is there something you would like to say to the citizens of White Creek?
Yes, and thank you. Dear citizens, I would like to apologize for my clear displeasure at the changing of tonight's film. This is a good moment for reminder that I honor the ministry's wisdom in all things, as we must all always do, and that I love and respect Arch Hall Jr. and Senior, respectively and together.
Great. On to tonight's first guest.
Yes, please. All right. Tonight, we are super excited to welcome to the show a couple who needs little to no introduction. White Creek's own 10-time Innertown Champions of the Foxtrot, Sid and Darlene, here to teach you all the merengue, which made a lot more splatting sense when we were doing Dirty Dancing, but, you know, whatever. It's fine. It's
all right. Fine. And here now are the just fine Sid and Darlene.
Today we're going to be covering, very much like the last couple of programs we've done for you, some of the music interpretation as well as a variety of different dances. We've decided to begin today with the merengue. Now, merengue is a Latin dance, and what this means to you is we will be doing the basically hip action, Latin footwork, which is like ball flat type action with the hip movement. The thing to remember about merengue is when you do this, it's an 8-count dance, very Latin dance. It'll fit just about any amount of music, or any type of music, I should say, but you do want to dance it to something like what we've just done it to, okay? So we're going to begin with our basic step. Having said that, gentlemen, as always, we're going to have you start with your left foot, and ladies, as always, we're going to have you start with your right foot. Now look for the, as far as the hip movement and the steps. The steps are not too difficult in this dance. So here we go. Guys, with your left foot, we're just going to do what we call a side chasse. So begin by having your weight completely placed on your right leg, your left leg bent forward a little bit, and ladies, weight completely on your right on your left leg with your left with your right leg bent a little bit. And all we're going to do is go side together, side together, side together, side together, using that ball flat footwork action. Once again, we'll have Michelle's back to you for this one. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Thank you.
Wait, was that you and Tommy Hall? No.
Let's hear it for Sid and Darlie. On with the show. On with the show.
Did you learn that at two left feet?
Bob,
you and Tommy Hall took dance lessons together.
On with the show.
Come on, they canceled dance in school. He is actually 10 years younger than you. Oh, now I get a reaction.
Nine.
Yeah.
Why are you putting us through this torture? You have our money and you're taking our car. Isn't that enough?
You keep your dirty hands off me. You think you're so much better than me. You kind of all think that way. You called me inhuman.
All right, I apologize. I shouldn't have said that. Now, will you let me go?
Call me an animal.
I'm sorry I said those things. Now, can I go?
You're sorry, but you still think it. You think I'm dirt. You think Judy's dirt. You'll always think it till you don't think no more. Your kind means nothing. You hear? Nothing! Why don't you scream? Maybe the big talker will come and help you. Maybe Miss Goody Good Good still thinks she's so much better than me. There's a fear to be touched by dead. Huh? Goody Good Good don't like it. Taste it! Taste it! Eat the dirt! Taste it! Goody Good don't think she's so much now, does she? She don't mind being touched by dirt. Get moving!
Yeah. What did he do to you, child?
It's all right, Mr. Oliver. It's all right.
Get back to work.
You want that car fixed? You can do it yourself.
Starting to be the big man again, huh?
You're the big man, Tibbs. That's the name, isn't it? Charlie Tibbs? The big man who killed 7 people, made them get on their knees and shot them in the head? Paper calls you a thrill killer. It must be a real thrill to wipe out a family of 5. How many thrills have you had since you left Arizona? What about the people here? Did you kill them too?
How long do you think you can keep getting away with this, son? The law's bound to catch up with you sooner or later.
And the law has ways of handling murderers.
Please don't antagonize him anymore.
What's going to happen to you?
If anybody opens their mouth again, I'll blow their brains out! Listen, big man, you get back to fixing that car, you're going to be a big dead man fast. All of a sudden, everybody's becoming the big talker.
Getting kind of brave.
Nobody wants to talk no more, Judy. Judy! Give me a soda! Just a little target practice.
shake the bottle up there. I need to get my head.
Mr. Oliver, they're going to do something terrible. I just know it.
You get up. Over there.
What are you gonna do?
Shut up. Move. That's far enough. Down on your knees. On your knees. Seeing as how you like to talk, go ahead and talk. Talk all you want. As soon as I finish this, you're gonna be through talking. School be out for you, teacher. Better start talking, mister. The time's running out.
You can't shoot me like this for no reason. For nothing. Surely blowing my head off can't give you a thrill. Is it money you need? I have close to $2,300 in the bank. Tomorrow you can call my wife. She'll give it to you, all of it. You and your girlfriend can have a lot of fun on $2,300.
He sure is talking a lot different than he did a while ago. Ain't he, Judy?
You have a father, don't you? Would you want someone doing this to him? Think of your own father in my place. Or yours.
Save your breath on her, mister. I'm the only thing in the world she has. Her old man's dead, and her old lady's a drunk.
Young lady, can't you realize this is wrong? You love him, don't you? You know what it is to be around someone you love and who loves you? I have loved ones, too. A daughter a little older than you, and son about his age. Please, I beg of you, talk to your boyfriend. Tell him this is wrong. Tell him, please. My God, child, haven't you any feelings at all? Can't you understand?
Look at him squirm, Judy. They all alike, ain't they? Yellow when they go.
You just can't wipe out a man's life like this. Not like this.
You just can't stand here and watch.
And you can't let him do this. Maybe he'll listen to you. Talk to him. Ed, talk to him.
Ed, single. Do something, somebody. Do something. Tell him you won't fix the car. Don't let him do it.
If you want the car fixed.
Maybe the big man wants to take your place. If he says one more word, he will. What about it, big man? You feel like talking? Maybe Miss Goodgood wants to take his place. I guess nobody wants to take your place, mister.
Mr.
school's out, teacher. No, no, please. Ed! Miss Baines!
Shut up!
Shut up yourself!
Doris, take control of yourself!
Do you, coward!
Doris!
Don't touch me!
Doris, you're gonna get us both shot!
I don't care, I don't care! Why don't you go ahead and shoot? Go on, shoot! Go on, go on, shoot, shoot! I don't care!
In another couple of minutes, I'll have the pump out.
Shut up!
It won't take very long to put it in the other car.
I said shut up!
You're going to need that car now, and I'm the only one that can fix it.
I ain't waiting too long.
Judy, go get me a soda.
And that pie, too.
Poor Edna. How will anybody be able to tell? His son's graduation.
Doris, believe me, I feel as badly as you. He's dead. Nothing can bring him back. We're alive. We've got to think of ourselves now. Do you think I wanted to stand there and watch him die? What could I do? What could anyone have done? You can't reason with that kid. He wants blood, Doris, and nobody's going to talk him out of it. Don't you understand what we're dealing with? He's a psycho, Doris. Well, should I have taken his place? Would that have made you feel better? What would you be saying to Carl if it was me lying over there?
Why don't we just run? The highway is only a few yards from here.
He cut us down before we got 5 feet.
I'll die running before I get on my knees. Like, I can still see him drinking that. Come by and stop.
Sure, Doris, maybe a car will pull in.
Pull in? They won't know. He'll kill them and us too. The police. Maybe the police will pass by. They do patrol this highway. They will, Ed. They will. We must find a way to make them stop, Ed.
Doris. Miracles do happen, but you can't count on them.
I'm sorry.
Now listen. I'm going to try to find out how many more shots he has left, or if he has reloaded or not.
But how will we find out?
4 shots we know of. That leaves 4. He probably shot the people here, too. There must have been 2. Remember what Carl told us about the settings in the kitchen?
Yes. 2 plates eaten from, and 2 plates untouched.
Tibbs must have surprised them while they were eating. They were too frightened to eat while those 2 were stuffing themselves. He shot them. That leaves 2 shots. Well, he certainly didn't walk here from Arizona. Maybe he shot someone else. And if he hasn't reloaded...
Go ahead and talk, mister. You talk all you want. You thinking somebody's gonna save you.
Why should I fix a car if you're gonna kill us anyhow?
You'll fix it. Because that lets you live a little longer. Like back there. I knew you were stalling. If you'd want to fix a car, you'd die right now.
You want this car, Tibbs. Who are you fooling? Well, you can kill us, but you'll be stranded.
That's a road, ain't it? Well, there's a road, there's cars. Somebody will pick us up. They always have.
Is that how you got here from Arizona?
The sailor picked us up.
How far did he take you?
Thought he was a real lover, huh, Judy?
Suppose you shot him, too.
No, I just cut his throat.
Why haven't you still got his car?
Run out of gas last night. You sure asking a lot of questions, mister. But you go ahead and ask all you want.
How did you get here?
A farmer picked us up. His old crate broke down up the road a piece. Bad. I was beginning to like that old codger.
Shoot him, too?
He sure prayed when he went, Judy. Remember? He reached for the sky and talked to the Lordy Lord.
Then you shot him.
Yeah. Right between the eyes.
What about the 2 people you shot here? Did they pray too?
You must think I'm dumb, mister. Don't know nothing. You're counting bullets. Count all you want. I can count too. You know I only fired 7 shots. Only got 1 bullet left.
Unless I reloaded.
How many bullets do I have left?
Come on, come on. You're the big man.
Come on.
The 1 bullet's gone.
Come on, maybe the gun's empty. Come on, miss, I'm giving you a chance.
Come on, big man.
Come on, mister.
Come get the gun. What's the matter? Your friend?
You had a chance, mister. You should have taken it. You ain't gonna get no more.
See how yellow they are, Judy? He's afraid of an empty gun.
Big man. Big talker.
All right. Welcome back. It has come to our attention and the ministry that tonight's broadcast, mandated broadcast, has been hijacked by pirates.
computers pirates.
Mm-hmm. The ministry is currently investigating the source of the transmission interference, and they'll figure out where it came from, and they have strong words for said pirate.
I'm a Pharisee, and I have yellow hair and a black heart.
No, I did not say that. Seriously, though.
My name is Mike D, and I like movies, 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 movies. Did I mention movies?
True.
I'm a dork.
Less true.
All right, whoever you are.
Okay, Tommy Hall.
Did we mention we're dorks?
Quickly. On to Maurice.
Quickly.
Quickly.
Maurice again. I'm not a special journey. I'm hunting for all the wonderful flowers all around the world and all around time for my love, for my cave woman. Follow me. This is the first one Maurice finds. Isn't it lovely? Oh, it smells so pretty. When you find that special someone, you need to find all the pretty things in the world to give to them. So maybe they see the pretty inside of you. There's more to find. Come, let's go. See? Such pretties. Put them all together. Show her what you can do. And maybe she'll come home with you. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention. You also need to wash off all your yummy Maurice stinky for your nice lady. That's your wash down. Yes, get nice and clean for her, for them, whoever. See, you find them special things. Oh, there's more. Oh, Maurice realized he has been showing you all the ways that Maurice know how to find someone and get them to like him. But I realize I'm very behind the now. What people do now is they put on their little boxes that they all carry around, they put little poses and little pictures and little dances to show how interesting and shiny and alluring they are so that you go, oh, I want to meet them. So now Maurice do it just like they do now. Posing, here we go. So now that you know all the ways that Maurice show you, you go out and you find that special someone, and you show them how wonderful you are. Okay.
Why didn't they mess with the Maurice feed? Can you hear my jacket?
Okay.
getting ready to do something.
You.
Dies. Keep her out of sight. She makes one noise. You slit her throat.
Hello, son. Sure a scorcher.
Sure is.
Don't recall having seen you around here before, son.
A friend of the family.
Just talked to Milt's son in town about an hour ago. Funny, being the talker he is, didn't mention anything about visitors.
He just left before I got in.
Lancaster, huh?
Yeah. Been working in the car. Fuel pump trouble.
Mine went out only last week. You know, Jim, it cost over $30 to get it fixed. Boy, what a crook that guy was. Look, somebody lost a 45 clip. Where's Milt?
Back someplace.
Well, he can get more parts out of a car than the factory put in it.
Yeah, he sure can.
Help!
I told you to keep quiet. Should've known what I told you. Get moving. I told you nobody could help you.
You're gonna have every officer in California looking for you.
They don't scare me. Nobody scares me. I'm gonna give you a choice, big man. You die now, or you fix that car. I'll give you 15 minutes to fix it.
Why should I fix it? You'll only kill us when I get done.
I'm giving you 15 more minutes of life, mister. If you don't want it, I'll blow your head off right now. There is two. 1 o'clock. You got until 1:15. You start working.
Who'd ever believe something like this?
They shoot two officers. There were two of them. Two of them.
Judy, give me that gun.
Minutes. What are we going to do?
Radio caller come 2 minutes earlier.
Got to do something.
Looks like we'll have to run for it. Wait a minute. Move closer. Get in front of me. I got an idea. It may not work, but at least it's your chance. It's obvious he doesn't know much about cars. Now look, when I get the pump in, I'll ask you to get in the car and start it. Leave it in neutral. I'll raise the motor from here. When I give you the first signal, I'll scratch my shoulder. When I do, you shift into drive and push down on the brake. Got that?
Yes.
the second signal. A wink. But hold on tight, because I'll be pulling the gas pedal to the floorboard. I'm going to try to lure him in front of the car.
Oh, Dad.
It's just a chance. We might not hit him, but if we can at least startle him, it may give me the few seconds I need. Let's just pray this doesn't kick out on us.
What if it does?
Run for it.
What if it won't let me get in the car?
It's a chance we'll just have to take.
You got 11 minutes.
Doris?
Car with you starting it. It's a beautiful day.
day for a ball game. Time is 1:10, still time to come on down. And now, stay tuned for Dodger Warm-Up.
We could just get them away from the car long enough to...
Music. All those people. Laughing and yelling. So happy. Words, I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
You're not going to die, Doris. Doris, get in the car and start it so I can see if the pump holds pressure. Doris, get in the car and start it.
Just a minute.
You want the car to run, I want to live those extra few minutes.
Now I have to check the pump for pressure.
All right. But it better run good.
Start it up.
You ain't got much more time. 2 minutes. How does it feel when you're about to die?
Try it now.
I think you're Yellowbelly. Yeah. One of them squirmers.
Welcome back, everybody. The ministry would like to inform you that tonight's pranking has gone far enough and that any additional interference of tonight's mandated programming will be met as an act of aggression against the ministry and its officers.
Us.
Correct.
So stop it.
Correct.
Yeah, stop it, computers pirates, because the ministry will find you and force you to write strongly worded apology letters.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Snack time!
Dreams and bones and bats and bones and teenage monsters in haunted homes, a ghost on the stair, a vampire's bite, but beware, there's a full moon tonight.
And what's on the menu tonight, Miss C?
Well, Mr. D, seeing as how it is Valentine's Day, and nothing says Valentine's Day like...
Hearts.
Yep.
Candy.
Yep.
And odes of amour.
Mm-hmm. Yep, yep, and yep. Tonight's dish includes all three and is a little family special that Mama C like to call mall pie.
Mm.
Delicious.
It sounds so good.
Mm-hmm.
Mall pie.
Step one, make a giant sugar cookie. Step two, cut the cookie into a heart. Step three, add a tub of frosting. Step four, add the icing. Step five, add some red hot, because what is love without a little spice? Step six, add the words of love. Step seven, put it in your mouth.
Wow-wee, that sure is lovely.
Isn't it though?
And now on to the most important step.
Yes, sir. Put it in your mouth.
Don't mind if I do.
Ooh.
Hard to.
It's crunchy.
It's a little
crunchy and
taste it! Eat the dirt!
Mm. Bob!
What the?
What's splatting? Splat! Bob!
She left her whole cookie.
It's a mall pie.
Get up. I said get out. Move.
You did something.
I did nothing.
I was running pretty good a few seconds ago. You must have did something.
Look, this pump has been in a wrecked car for who knows how long. Now, sometimes they get clogged and don't hold the pressure. I should take it out and clean it.
You ain't got time for that.
It's not holding pressure. It needs to be cleaned.
You're looking for time, ain't you?
It won't take very long.
We ain't taking nothing out! You think you're fooling me, don't you? Think I don't run nothing but cars, don't you? That thing right there, that's a carburetor. The car can't run unless there's gas in it. All you gotta do is prime it. Now, I seen that done. So you prime it. Go on, there's a gas pump over there.
Get in the car and start it when I tell you to.
Nobody gets in that car but me.
If I'm gonna prime it, somebody has to pump the gas pedal.
Just never you mind. You just put that gas in that carburetor.
Thank you. Thank you. here for you fans who enjoy the Dodgers and the Red Lakes. If you're close by, won't you come on down? You'll enjoy it here at Dodger Stadium. A gorgeous day, shirt sleeve crowd, everybody having a wonderful time. Okay, we're set to go. The bases loaded, bottom of the first inning. Ron fairly up there. Perky, the great pitcher of the Red Lakes, set to go. He faces him. He has his sign. There's the windup. The pitch. Fairly belts it. Oh, what a smash. Frank Robinson is on his bicycle. He's going back. He turns and races toward the wall. Back, back, back he goes. Oh, it's a home run.
All right, everybody, so The Sadist. Now, I sure do love that movie. I sure do wish that we could have watched it without all of that stupid piracy.
Well, next time, Missy, because let me tell you why. The Ministry has triangulated the computer pirates' transmission, and the signal stopped broadcasting.
Additionally, the Ministry has set up a tip line for anybody that has information to aid in the apprehension and capture of tonight's unlawful pirates.
We are joined now by the renowned Dr. Klaus to talk love, relationships, and those tacky boxed chocolates. Thank you for joining us, Dr. Klaus. As per our Valentine's Day tradition, we will be joined now for letters from you, the denizens of White Creek, to Dr. Klaus, relationship expert. All right. Letter one. Doctor, I have been having a hard time connecting with my wife emotionally. All she ever seems to care about is family, family, family. But I just have other interests. Any tips on how to spice things up? And what's your favorite barbecue sauce to use on a traditional fried V-loaf? That's from Ben Coyote, proud family man.
Ben Coyote, thank you for reaching out. First of all, you need to kind of do what I consider the microwave relationship. It speeds things up. I'm a relationship in a minute. You get the family, lure them into a cage and have a cage match. Winner takes all. And it is like quick bonding. Less work, you know, more time for you. Second, my favorite V-loaf thing is a kind of a marshmallow fluff garlic rub, and it you gives too. Yes, I recommend it with the little cedar chips. It's good.
That sounds good.
Excellent.
Letter two. This comes from Sal Gal Groovy, Doctor. What are some of the best love songs to listen to get your, let's say, amigo in the mood for a hot hug? Also, what's your favorite vegetable rub for back pain? Salgal Groovy.
Okay, Salgal Groovy. I wanted to reach out to you to say what you do first is you look for the songs that speak like Amigo Love.
Amigo
this
love.
Is a good one.
Yeah.
Amigo Love. You know, Guy Headbutt, the Mosh song is really good. It's actually the title Guy Headbutt, the Mosh song, because it got confused with
it's
the vocal.
It's in, what do you call them, parentheses?
I guess.
Yeah.
It's like bracket. Scratching.
So, oh.
Anyways. Sorry, I digress. Anyways, vegetable rub is a celery compote with real fire ants.
Okay.
You rub it on. The heat. The heat.
So use celery compost and fire ants. Letter three. All right. Hey, what gives? You never read my smail on air. Wait, what? How can this be? You're reading it now. Oh my goodness gracious, you're actually reading it live. Mike D, raise your hand if you are reading it live on the air right now. Honey, come here. They're reading my message on the show. Oh, I better ask. What's the most romantic thing a partner can say to their true love.
Mr. Taimo, I know it is you that wrote this. You think you can come on this show and just make glib comments and make light of our feud? Well, we'll see what the feuding is like. Look in the future to see what I will do to you. Okay. Also, the love part is, I think, what you do is you say, you're dreamy, and then you headbutt them, and the concussion makes the words echo through their mind. And so they just hear, you're dreamy, you're dreamy, you're dreamy. They fall in love 100 times with the, you know, the love headbutt.
Yeah, they certainly fall. All right, letter 4. Hey, I only wrote something here to distract you from discovering this letter's true intent. To say Sarah C. and Mike D. doo-doo head both have booger mouth. No questions, only fire. Okay.
Okay, this is all gray area, this question. So it's kind of hard to really get into the specifics. Nothing's black and white about this question.
Well, it's black. You don't have to answer it. We're not going to. No.
I had a great answer.
You could give the answer.
Moment's gone.
What was the question?
That is the question.
All right, letter 5. Doctor. Okay, this one's going to be proper. Doctors. Klaus.
I'm a doctor.
Scaracy and Mike D. D. Poo Poo P. P. Are you human or are you? Answer. Splathouse sucks. A butt's worth of fat farts. Baba. Booey. All right, no, this is.
Are really any of us human? Or are we just naked apes lost on this world, trying to find meaning in love songs and vegetable rubs?
Yeah, we're naked apes. Oh, marshmallows. Yes, it is time for the annual feeding of Dr. Klaus. We have his marshmallows. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. We have obviously been hacked, so we are going to be getting out of here as quickly as we can.
Mm-hmm. Next week, our family road trip is none other than...
Something Manos the Hands of Fate.
Manos the Hands of Fate. Until then, here is the phone number again. Mm-hmm. And as always, remember that sharing is caring, and that includes information leading to the apprehension of unlawful pirates.
Yeah.
Happy Valentine's Day, citizens.
F*** you, Tommy Hall.
We out.
The heat is in the music. The music sets you dancing.
Every place we go.
The dancing sets her free. Vestron Pictures presents Dirty Dancing. She thought it would be just another summer vacation.
Who's that?
Oh, them. They're the dance people.
But it turns out to be the time of her life.
Watch me now!
I can't even do the merengue.
He teaches her what she can do.
I'm not sure who you are, but I don't want you to have anything to do with those people again.
I'm scared of everything. Most of all, I'm scared of walking out of this room and never feeling the rest of my whole life the way I feel when I'm with you.
What they learn from each other feels too good to be wrong. Dirty Dancing, starring Patrick Swayze, Jennifer Grey, and Cynthia Rhodes. Get ready for the time of your life.
Next up on the mandated Slumber Party Sleepover,